Hit subscribe so that you don't miss another update from India Film Project.
A very warm welcome to India Film Project Talk Shop Episode 9. The guest that we have today, from being an interviewer to being an interviewee, from being a person behind the cameras to being a person in front of cameras, from being a film critic to being a director, he is quite versatile with his career choices. He has won multiple awards for his films. We have the dude-looking director, Kunal Kohli, on the sets of India Film Project Talk Shop. A very warm welcome, sir.
Thank you, Megha.
While we rewind this handsome-looking dude sitting in front of me, say 15 years back, while he was working with Zee as a channel, as a film critic, and then, being a filmmaker who's a celebrated filmmaker.
So when I was in the first standard and the teacher gave us the composition, like what you did in your holidays. So, and she said, you have to write what you did in your holidays. So I raised my hand. She said, yes, Kunal, what is it? I said, why do I have to write it? She said, what do you mean, why do you have to write it? You have to write it. How else will you say it? I said, can't I draw it and show you in pictures what happened in my holidays?
In class one, wow.
In class one.
Yes.
So, and then in class two, there was a class play, which obviously the teacher was putting up the whole play. I remember it was about the Greek gods, and there were different Greek gods, Olympus and this and that. I'm sorry, Olympus was the mountain where they stayed. All the Greek gods were there, and she was setting up the play. So again, I raised my hand. She said, yes, Kunal. So I said, I want to do what you're doing. She said, what do you mean? I said, I want to set up the play. She said, but you don't know how. I said, yeah, but I want to do it. Basically, I was trying to say that I want to direct the play. So as far back as I can remember, I wanted to direct, whether it was, and I wanted to visually say stories. So, and when I didn't get the opportunity, I wasn't a film kid, nothing to do with the film industry,
yes,
struggling to get a foothold into the industry. There weren't so many studios in those days, nothing. So I said, okay, if I can't get a chance to make films, at least I'll talk about films.
Right.
So I started Chalo Cinema. A film critique show, because I said, "Acha, film mein bana nahi sakta hu, filmon ke bare mein baat to kar lo."
Critics, they can make a film or break a film.
No, I don't agree with that, because I don't think critics or anyone can make or break a film, except for the makers and the public. A critic's job is only to critique a film. Critiquing is not about talking about how much business a film is going to do. Anyway, but that's all part and parcel of filmmaking. So it just comes with the territory.
So your journey as a film critic to now, coming to 2004 as a filmmaker, while Hum Tum released, it was such a rage, those cartoons, animated version, which might have such an impactful, entry as far as a filmmaker is concerned. Of course, considering other films, this film was the one which till date is remembered when it comes to Kunal Kohli.
Yes, Hum Tum is looked at as a landmark film and a cult film, especially for rom-coms. It was the first film that actually created the rom-com genre in the country, so to speak.
So I want to come to this point where, at that point of time in 2004, when Hum Tum was released, we also had a stalwart making a film called Veer Zara and Main Hoon Na. They were both, again, huge films. And you took away multiple awards back home.
There was also Swadesh.
Yes.
There was also Khaki.
There was also Laksh.
In fact, all these films were nominated. And I was just happy to be nominated. Honestly, yeah. I was just happy that I'm nominated. I said, award to milega nahin. There's no chance I'm going to get the award against all these people. Against Ashu for Swadesh, Farhan for Laksh, Farah for Mehuna, Khaki, Raj Santoshi Khaki. Well, Hum Tum was also a Yash Raj film.
Yes.
But it was Yashji who's my mentor, who was my producer.
Yes.
And one of the reasons why I got into films. I got into films because of filmmakers like Yash Chopra. Because it was 50th year of Filmfare, they awarded a special Filmfare award to Mr. Ramesh Sippy for Sholay.
Right.
So Mr. Ramesh Sippy goes on stage, picks up the Filmfare, and he says, so this is how one of these feel. He said, I've never got one in my life. And I'm looking at Mr. Ramesh Sippy and I'm saying, what? He never got an award for best director in his life? So he's one of the biggest directors in this country and he has not got an award and I am crying with my little film ki yaar mere ko award mil jaye. I said, tum ho kaun Kunal Kohli, chup baitho. And then Mr. Rakesh Roshan came on stage and he came to announce best director. And he said, and the best director award goes to Kunal Kohli for Hum Tum. And I'm just sitting there, I'm like, what? And I was just numb.
You pinched yourself?
I was just numb. Okay, I didn't know what was happening.
True.
And I got up and I walked and I, of course, passed Yashji. Yashji was there, he congratulated me. And I reached stage.
And where Veer Zara was also nominated.
Where Veer Zara was, that's okay. These are small things in life.
Yeah.
You know, because I'll tell you why. You can never win over someone like that.
Yes,
okay,
true.
So it's not that.
Did you stammer with your thank you speech? You
well, you know, I used to stammer as a child. Okay, I sometimes still do stammer in life. In fact, strangely, I used to stammer with my own name. It used to be very difficult for me to say Kunal Kohli. I was almost like Shah Rukh Khan of Dar.
You know, like Kiran.
So I used to go Kunal.
Huh.
So I couldn't say my own name. I used to stammer as a child. Okay. And then I devised a trick. I would say, it's Kunal Kohli. You know, then the stammer would not come.
Oh.
Then when I stop stammering, I don't know. And when I do stammer in life, I don't know. It just happens sometimes.
If, you know, from host to a filmmaker to then, the journey moved from that transition from behind the camera to in front of the camera as an actor, as the lead hero of a film with a girl who was almost, 10, 12, 15 years younger to you?
Well, that journey is still not complete because the film is not released as yet.
Yeah, but
so
it
that
is shot
journey
completely,
is,
right?
The film is shot and it's ready and it's awaiting release and we had a few issues here and there and hopefully it should be released soon. That was a very interesting journey. I made this film Phir Se. It's about a man in his 40s and a woman in her 20s. And it's about the difference in society, the way society looks at a divorced man and a divorced woman, and how differently we look at a divorced man and a different woman. Even today, when we think we're a modern progressive society, we are not. We're not as progressive as we think we are. But yeah, so that was even a... I just wanted to try it. I think it's nice to try everything. So I said, let me see.
How did the transition happen? Who actually convinced you of coming, you know, changing your sides from this side to this side
so
of the camera?
What I did was, I thought about it. I said, should I try acting? Because I, whenever I'm explaining a scene to my actors, I always act it out and show it to them. So I just said, should I try doing this role? And I had written the role and everyone said, you know what, you're perfect for the role. Why don't you do it? So I said, no, that's not how I should do it. So what I did was I called Barry John and I told him, I said, sir, I'm going to call you for 3 weeks.
Right.
You have to come, not any of your teachers, because I think I would be at par with your teachers. I can also teach acting, but I can't. I'm not at your level for sure as a teacher. I want you to come to my office every day for 3 weeks. We're going to discuss a script. I'm going to perform a script. You're going to help me perform a script for 3 weeks.
Okay.
At the end of 3 weeks, I want you to tell me that, Kunal, you cannot be an actor. You are not an actor. So I want you to come and do this exercise with me. So, yeah, so that's how I convinced myself to do it because Mr. Barry John said I could.
So even before you decided to act, you had an acting coach for yourself and that too a very well reputed one. So why don't we talk about...
Because I'll tell you why. Because I find it very strange that today when people want to be an actor, they go to a gym. I don't understand that. It's like saying...
This is to be quoted.
It's like saying, I want to be a chef, so let me go for a swim.
Completely true.
If you want to be a chef, you go to a kitchen and you cook. You want to be an actor, you go to an acting coach and you learn acting. But no, today this whole country, I want to be an actor, let me go to a gym. Where's the connection? Where is the connection between acting and a gym?
You are being trained at a gym by Mahesh Bhatt Saab's son, Rahul. Is that right or wrong? Or
I was.
You were.
But
with Aamir Khan is when you get trained together.
He's also
together.
In the same gym. We're all, I mean, a couple of us go to the gym. That is for health reasons.
Yes,
so because
of course,
what happened in my with my lifestyle and pressures and everything, okay, I got high blood pressure. So the doctor told me that you have to take these high blood pressure pills every day. I said, okay, so I started taking them for a while. Then I met Rahul Bhatt somewhere and he said, why don't you start exercising? And my blood pressure was back to normal.
Okay.
So that's why I go to the gym now at least 5 times a week, not to become an actor, to maintain my health.
If I ask you whether your mom or dad, who inspired you or rather appreciated you more to take this as a career?
Nobody aage peeche in my family was from the film industry.
Yes.
And so it was, they were very, very upset that I wanted to do things like this. And one of my uncles had an audio recording studio in Lamington Road. And I started in college going there and learning audio recording. Then he was one of the first people in this country to get video recording equipment into the country. And today it's all digital, but those were the days when there were tapes. So, and we had beta tapes. Before beta we had high band, before high band we had low band. So in low band days I was working. And okay. I started off by being a camera attendant. I used to go with the camera for shootings.
Right.
And like even today, if anything happens with any of the cables here, I can solder it and set it up as well as any of the people on this set can do. Right. Because I've done that job also. So I've been a camera attendant. I've been an assistant editor. I've edited. I've done all these things because I just wanted to do something.
True.
And I kept doing all this and my parents kept looking at me and saying, okay, but when are you going to start working? And I never did. In their terminology, I started working. I never started working.
So you had siblings?
Yeah, one sister.
So you were ever compared to her or somewhere? You
know?
Because
no,
a creative
really.
Choice of career at that point of time.
No, my sister didn't get into a career as such. She got married and then she went off to America. So she, and then she started working when she was there. But and academically, she was way ahead of me. She was house captain and everything. And I was requested by my headmistress that please don't stay back in school. Please go and do junior college outside the school. We've had enough of you. If you can leave, it'll be very nice. But so having said all that, so when I was doing all these things and then ZTV was starting and I got a job in ZTV and I started working over there. And my mom was... she was working. She was in fact one of the people responsible for privatization of airlines in the country, and she was working in a company called Modi Luft at that time. And Modi Luft had just started and she was in Dubai in some meeting over there. And people asked her, so what does your son do, Mrs. Kohli? And she was very embarrassed and she said, he works in ZTV. So, and cut to, I get a phone call from her in Dubai and she's crying and crying on the phone. I said, what happened? So she said, no, I'm here at this party and everybody knows you here and I'm so proud of you. And I never thought that what you were doing was any work, but I just realized that,
wow,
you know, you are actually doing something with your life. So I'm like, thanks, Ma. And so she was just, it was a big moment in her life where she realized that in Dubai, everyone at the party knew who her son was.
So again, now, you know, we again travel a little ahead. So from host to a filmmaker to an actor to a son, we went through that journey. And now I'm just, you know, going back 10 minutes back on the sets while you just entered. And you started, you know, dressing up yourself. You came in a white t-shirt. You asked if I could change and I can wear a jacket if you want. We said, yes, sir, if you would. You started dressing up. And while standing there and dressing up, we offered you a washroom. We said, sir, if you would want. And you, something which you just shared was interesting, the trivia.
No, I just said, well, it was like, you know, I was shooting with Saif in LA for Thoda Pyaar Thoda Magic. Unfortunately, the film didn't do well and didn't turn out that well also. And he was like, okay, Saif, where do you want to change? You want to go to that restaurant? He said, no, he just put his pants and he just changed in the middle of the road. Took out his shirt, changed in the middle of the road. And I think that's just, you know, you just got to be comfortable with yourself. And I realized we have so many nakhras. You know, the way films are promoted nowadays, I know you haven't asked me this question and I'm just saying it. The way films are promoted nowadays is more like a goddamn fashion show as opposed to talking about the film. You'll have a film that's about rural India or set in a small town of India and the heroine will be wearing gowns and going for promotions. And every day it will be hair by so-and-so, costume by so-and-so, shoes
by so-and-so.
This is my promotion look. What is promotion look, for God's sake?
True.
What the hell is promotion look? I mean, what are we doing? You know, talk about the film. I don't want to know about your clothes. In fact, I feel very soon it'll be like heroines will start tweeting, 1 year of promotions of this film. She won't say 1 year of my film, 1 year of promotions of this film. That's what's going to happen after a while. Anyway, carry on.
Because you're talking about clothes. It's so crazy. I mean, so of course, then that might be the, you know, more hectic schedule they might be following rather than why this film was being shot.
Just look at Bahubali and Lipstick Under My Burkha. There are two examples of films that were not promoted in malls. Or the way films are promoted and heroines putting up their Instagram pictures of costumes every day.
So there goes a very obvious question that, you know, now I heard somewhere that you're also making a film with Tamanna.
Yes, I've finished shooting that film.
Oh, it's
in Telugu.
Yes.
And
you understand the language completely?
No, not at all. Just a few words which I picked up while shooting. But I wrote the script in English.
Right.
I got it translated, not translated, I got someone to write the dialogues in Telugu. Then I got someone else to read the dialogues in Telugu and explain to me what they'd written. Then I went back to the dialogue writer and said, no, these points you've written it wrongly. So I got that done. Then on the set, because I knew what they were saying, I mean, I didn't know though the language, but I knew what they are saying, what the meaning of what they were saying was. I would tell the actors, no, you know what, this is wrong. Right. Don't say it like this, say it like this. The meaning of this is this. And I had a great time. I think, you know, we always say art has no language.
True.
And it's really true. I thought, and I finished the film in like under 30 days. And it was just with songs, big songs, lavish locations, shot all over the UK, grand scale of the film. It's a big production. I had a wonderful time and I did not at any point in time feel, or the actors ever feel, that there was a language barrier. And I think that is something that is so wonderful that we are not exploring enough of. You know, we have divided ourselves so much in this country. Telugu industry separate, Kannad is separate, Malayalam is separate,
Marathi.
Tamil is separate, Marathi is separate, Hindi is separate, this is separate, that is separate, Punjabi is separate. We're all filmmakers. Which is why the other day I got very upset. I read one filmmaker had said somewhere about city filmmakers and how filmmakers who've come from outside Bombay gave Bollywood a new look, a new language and all. I'm like, yaar, and I messaged him also. I said, dude, what are you doing here? I said, there's not enough division you want to divide city filmmakers in that. I said, even within the city, Ashu, Farhan, Madhur, Vipul, me, Adi, Karan, we all have a different language and a different voice.
Right.
So I said, you can't have outsiders and yahan ke filmmakers or wahan bahar se aane. I said, kya hai yaar ye? I told him, kabhi milo yaar, drink piyo saath mein, let's get rid of your stereotypes.
So while you're talking this, my collars are going up. I'll tell you why. At India Film Project, we have, since 2011, we get participants from across 30 countries in 256 cities across the world. And interestingly, like have you just said, you know, we have a lot of filmmakers from down south. Since last 2-3 years, they win the final award, the platinum film and the gold film and all of it. So while you just said that there's no, you know, language barrier as far as art or understanding art form is concerned. So we have a few patrons who watch those short films being made at India Film Project. Somebody sitting in Turkey, they watch the film being made by person in Tamil Nadu. So
well, but that's what has to happen. Like while I was shooting in London, I met Shekhar Kapoor. We went out for dinner. I've known him for years. And it's so amazing what Shekhar has achieved. So there's an Indian man who's making a film on Bruce Lee. He's made a film, he's made a TV series on William Shakespeare. He's made films on Elizabeth.
Wow.
And he's an Indian guy. And that's what cinema is all about. That's what we all should strive to achieve. I told him, I said, I want to grow up and be you.
Wow!
I do. I want to grow up and be Shekhar Kapoor. Actually, once when I was a kid, I even kept a beard because I was so much in love with Shekhar.
Oh, wow!
My heroes and gurus have always been filmmakers.
Filmmakers.
Actors, of course. Mr. Bachchan has always been my idol. But I was more starstruck and I used to always follow the careers of filmmakers, Indian filmmakers. So there were Shekhar, Ramesh Sippy, Subhash Ghai, Yash Chopra, Manoj Kumar, Vijay Anand. I've been like fans of theirs. Gurudat, you know, Mahesh Bhatt. Not, unfortunately, the current films he makes, but the only films that he made as a director.
So you just back to back announced the Geeta, Bible and Quran of Bollywood back to back. All the names that you've
seen. Well, they are mine. I didn't get a chance to work with them.
Not just for you,
but I always say they were. I was like the Eklavya and these were my Dronacharyas. I was fortunate to have all of them as my Dronacharyas. I worked with Bhatt Saab. Not in films. There were these video magazines, Bollywood Plus, People Plus and Business Plus, which Amit Khanna was making and Mahesh Bhatt was in charge of Bollywood Plus. And so Bhatt Saab and me were handling Bollywood Plus. So I worked for about a year and a half or 2 years with Bhatt Saab very closely.
Right.
So we have this beautiful relationship.
I
met him once somewhere and he was like, are you still making those fake candy floss romances and selling fake dreams? I said, Bhatt Saab, it's better than the sex you're trying to sell. And people are getting shocked, like, what does he say? But we have that equation. I can talk to him like that because I love him so much.
You worked for 3 years, is what you just said.
No, and we had a different equation. It was just because I love Mahesh Bhatt as a filmmaker. I thought some of the films he's made were absolutely incredible. I think, like, till today, I feel Saransh is an internationally brilliant film. It's a film that's not only just stands the test of time, but it's truly an international piece of work. It is absolutely brilliant. Saransh, Sadak, Janam, Naam, Arth, brilliant films. I think he made some of the most brilliant films.
And while you are just talking about this, I don't know how relevant it is, but in this season of Talk Shop, almost every director we had on the set had to have uttered two words called Satyajit Ray. And while you announced some 10-15 names of film directors, you did not. So I have always heard from film directors, of course, makers, that not watching a Satyajit Ray's film is like being in a world with no sun and no light and no moon. So,
well, I don't think there's anything like that. I feel it's just like when you said that I'm good looking, and I said that's subjective. Okay. There is no, like, I think one of, Citizen Kane is considered the best film ever made.
Yes.
Okay, I got bored in Citizen Kane. I couldn't sit through it.
Subjective.
Okay, so it's subjective. I'm not saying that Mr. Satyajit Ray is not a great filmmaker.
Yes.
Okay, have I seen all his works? No. Am I a lesser human being for that? No. If you want to judge me, that's your prerogative. You can judge me. You know, I think Bimal Roy is a great filmmaker. Who's not so much spoken about. I feel Raj Khosla is a great filmmaker. I feel there are so many filmmakers who are not spoken about so much. Raj Khosla, for one, I think he's really made some of the most brilliant films that this country has had. Manoj Kumar, I get really irritated and angry when people make fun of Manoj Kumar and when people laugh at Manoj Kumar. I think that is extremely and these are people who've done nothing in their lives, who have the audacity to laugh at a genius like Manoj Kumar.
So if I have to ask you, as a writer, as a host, as a director, as an actor, as a producer, what is the most difficult out of all?
I love writing. I love directing. I love editing. I love when I'm doing songs on a set. I love when I'm doing scenes. I love every aspect of filmmaking. I love song recording. I'm just obsessed with cinema. So you make me do anything on a film set, I'm happy. Just keep me on a film set. Jina yaha, marna yaha. Another great filmmaker whose name I don't know how I forgot to mention, Nasir Hussain. Nasir Hussain Saab was getting a Lifetime Achievement Award. And he came on stage and he got the award. And I'm waiting to hear what Nasir Hussain will say. I'm like, Nasir Hussain, man, greatest filmmaker. This, that, and the other. And he comes on stage, picks up the award, and he says, exactly like this, achhi filmein bas ban jaati hain. And he walked off stage. And I was so disappointed. I said, "Arey yaar." I said, "Okay, maybe he's become old. He doesn't know what he's saying. Doesn't have much to say. That's why he just said one simple line: 'Achhi filmein bas ban jaati hain.'" Then I became a filmmaker, and I realized how true that statement is. Achhi filmein bas ban jaati hain. You cannot take credit. I can't stand on a pedestal and say, "I made Hum Tum. I made Fanaa. I did this." It just happened. There was a team that got together, and everyone contributed something, and the film got made. So that line is so true what Nasir Hussain Saab said, achhi film mein bas ban jaati hai. So you were talking about a film of mine that you really like, Break Ke Baad. It's very strange. Today I meet people and they say they like the film, but at that time nobody came to the theatre to see the film. But I don't think the public was wrong, because honestly I don't think the film was that good.
I loved it.
No, well, you know, I'll tell you something. The script was wonderful.
Yes, it was.
I think somewhere in the making, that did not come out as well. I feel the film could have been much better. In fact, one day, in some language, I am going to remake that film. And hopefully, it'll be a better film than what was made.
So, because you've made music videos, I'm sure you might also have that, you know, understanding of music. And even your films, while we closely notice, the songs are brilliant always, you know. So when it comes to music, how much is your contribution as far as deciding every part of it is concerned?
Every music piece I'm involved in, not just picking up, not just selecting the tune, how we process the tune, what we do with that tune, every last detail I go into, because I, like I said, I'm obsessed. I've got OCD also, I think. So I can't leave anything to anybody.
So first the melody is finalized and then...
So yes, first I select the melody, for which I drive the music director mad because I have to like the melody. Sometimes what happens is there's a tune, it's like in 3-4 parts. So I tell him, I like the first part, I like the fourth part, I don't like the second and third part. So remove that, keep these two, change this in the middle. So he keeps this part of the tune and this part of the tune and changes, beech ka kuch change karke wapis sudhara jata hai.
So you don't leave it completely on the music director's...
No, I leave it, but I keep telling him what to do, how to do, where to go
completely.
About it. I'm involved in it. Of course, you all heard Chaand Sifarish. So Chaand Sifarish was not like this earlier. Okay, it was a much slower tune.
Right.
It was a much slower tune. And it was two options I had for mere haath mein. And it was like... ये दिल ही जाने तू क्या है मेरा रे या फिर जाने खुदा. So that it was that slow.
Right.
And for this situation, we were not getting a melody that I was happy with.
Right.
So then I went back to Jatin Lalit and I said Jatin da, ऐसे करते हैं ये जो गाना है ना.
हाँ.
I said इसका टेम्पो बढ़ाओ.
हाँ.
और इसमें I said सलीम सुलेमान को बुलाते हैं, इसको एक रॉक कवाली टाइप ऑफ चीज बनाते हैं.
राइट.
ऐसे इसको थोड़ा अग्रेसिव बनाते हैं, ये बहुत धीमी धीमी बहुत प्यारा सा धुन है जो आपने बनाया है, अब इसको थोड़ा चेंज करते हैं, इसको थोड़ा अग्रेसिव करते हैं. देन प्रसून केम अप विद द ब्रिलियंट लाइन, चांद सिफारिश जो करता हमारी. नाउ दिस इज सच एन एरोगेंट मैन, बिकॉज जनरली टिल चांद सिफारिश, चांद हैज ऑलवेज बीन यूज्ड टू प्रेज अ गर्ल.
राइट.
मैंने पूछा चांद से, चांद जैसा मुखड़ा, चांदनी ओ मेरी चांदनी. बट दैट्स व्हाट आई वांटेड.
राइट.
एंड दैट्स व्हाट प्रसून गेव मी एरोगेंस इन द आई सेड ये एक शायराना अंदाज होना चाहिए जिसमें एक एरोगेंस है, एक अदा है.
हु इज अ 3 AM फ्रेंड फ्रॉम बॉलीवुड हुम यू कैन कॉल एनी टाइम?
प्रसून.
प्रसून?
प्रसून एंड आमिर.
आमिर.
प्रसून एंड आमिर आर my 3 AM friend. I have only 2 friends in the film industry jise main dost bula saku. Prasoon is not like friend, he is like family.
While discussing your friends, it comes to family now. You have a cute little baby called Radha, whom you have adopted now.
She came to us when she was 6 months, and I think it's been the most wonderful 6.5 years of my life.
So awesome. You named her or?
Yeah, I just saw her and Radha came to my mind. So I just called her Radha.
Is your wife, she is also into the same industry, she's been part of a TV channel, she's been heading a TV channel and all of it.
Yeah.
So, who keeps more busy, you or her?
There are times.
Depends,
there
of course.
There are times. There are times when she was running a channel, she was more busy and I was sitting at home, I had no work to do, so I was sitting at home. Now, I was making a film and she didn't have anything to do. So, it's this time, our industry is like that.
So, you know, I've heard somewhere that you place those claps of your... whatever film you've made till now, on the walls, you framed them?
Yeah, in my office.
So
in my office, because I think the one thing that represents your film is the clap.
Yes.
And I find it very strange that after the film, the clap is lost. I've kept the clap of every film of mine. And it's framed and it's kept somewhere in the office.
So the next we have up for you is called Build a Scene. With this segment, I give you a character, a location and a property, and spontaneously you are supposed to build a nice story out of it. The character which I can think of right now is a guitarist.
Okay.
Who is obsessed with his guitar.
Should be.
Location is Taj Mahal. And the property is a coffee.
So, this man is there and he is sipping his coffee and looking at the Taj Mahal, and someone comes up to me and says, "Oye, idhar coffee peena mana hai." Aur baat batao, aap idhar 2 ghante se kya kar rahe hai? Aap aata hai jata hai, aata hai jata hai. The guard has come there. Ek baar dekh liya jao na, auron ko bhi aane do, bheed badha raha hai idhar. So, he said, "Tumhare paas aur koi kaam nahi hai, kya karte ho?" He said, "Nahi sir, main guitarist hu." To he said, "Guitar kahan hai?" He said, "Nahi, main guitarist hu, main dhun bhi banata hu. Lekin ab main coffee isliye pee raha hu kyunki koi dhun aa nahi rahi hai." So he said, "Kaise guitarist ho, dhun nahi aa rahi hai? Matlab tu to bilkul flop guitarist hai." He said, "Nahi, main bahut romantic dhune banata hu. To main idhar aaya tha inspiration lene ke liye." To he said, "To fir kya hua? Coffee pee raha hai, guitar kahan hai?" He said, "Isko dekh ke ab main kya dhun banau? Kuch samajh mein nahi aa raha hai ki main dhun kya banau. Taj Mahal ko dekh ke main kya dhun banau? Main dhun ke piche pada hu. Aur ye और इसने तो ताजमहल बना दिया तो मैं क्या करूं?" सर ये बात भी सही है.
हाँ.
तो सर आप क्या करते हो इधर? सर अगर देखो, अगर मैं आपके जैसे सोचने लग गया कि इसने ताजमहल बनाया तो मैं क्या करूंगा,
हाँ.
तो मेरा तो काम ही नहीं होगा.
हाँ.
मैं आपके जैसे नहीं सोचता हूँ कि इसने ताजमहल बनाया. मेरा काम है इधर कॉफी पीने वाले को भगाना. चल भाग. सो इट जस्ट द मॉरल ऑफ द स्टोरी इज, don't see what other people are doing. Do what you're doing. So that watchman over there probably had more character than the guitarist who came there to get inspired. Can go to the Taj Mahal and, you know, get inspired and things like that.
All right. Another section of this very same segment called Build a Scene, where I give you two characters and a location, and those two characters are your own.
Okay.
You have developed them as a writer, director, maker of the film. Yeah.
Okay.
One character I can think of is Zuni, Kajol from Fanaa, and the other which we've thought of is Saif Ali Khan from Hum Tum,
okay.
Karan Kapoor wala character.
Yes.
And the location is a trial room in a mall.
Zuni is there and Karan Kapoor is there, and Karan Kapoor looks at her and says, "Hi." She says, "Adab." So he says, "That's cool. I like this whole Adab vibe you got going." So she says, "What do you mean Adab vibe?" So he says, "No, I mean nowadays nobody says Adab." So she says, "Which part of the world are you from?" So he says, "No, I live in London, but you know, I come to India sometimes for a holiday. I've come with my daughter." Now he has a daughter. And she said, "Okay." So he says, so he said, "Do you have any children?" She says, "Yes, I have a son, Rehan." She says, "Oh, cool." He says, "What does your husband do?" She looks at him and says, "My husband was accused of being a terrorist." He's like, "Dude, are you serious? Are you like kidding me? Do I need to run away from here?" So she said, "No, don't worry. I shot him." So he's like, "What the?" and she's like, "Yeah, if you try to flirt with me, that's what I'll do to you as well." He just runs from there.
Gets inside the trial
room. He's gone. He ran away from the mall.
He locks himself in the trial room.
He just ran away from the mall, and that was the end of the scene. No one messes with Zuni.
All right. After this fictional segment that we just had called Build a Scene, we move ahead with the next section where let's get real now. We know that you're very, very regular on Twitter. So what we do is we show you a few tweets and we want your reaction on those.
"Best of luck on your new venture, Kunal Kohli. Love and luck, best of luck." Oh, so Varun is my cousin.
Varun Dhawan happens to be your cousin?
Yeah. So like I said earlier, no one in my family was from the film industry. Now we have a lot of people in my family who are from the film industry. My mother is the elder sister, and Lali Masi, Varun's mother, is the youngest.
So that's the first cousin.
Rohit and Varun are both my younger brothers. Ooh, they're wow. My cousins. They're okay. Very close family.
To which
Karan was wishing me for my film, and Varun also was wishing me for my film.
Yes.
Karan, I have a very close association with, because Karan introduced me to Adi.
Right.
When it was a situation like this, and I was doing Chalo Cinema, and Kuch Kuch Hota had released, and I was interviewing Karan. I was there, and Karan was here. And so Karan introduced me to Adi.
All right, next please.
Yeah, well, 1100 retweets, 1448 likes. Just don't want to up to win anywhere, which is why I suppose this tweet was so liked and so discussed. I very rarely talk about politics.
Yeah, that's what we get.
A good opposition is a very healthy thing in a democracy.
Right.
A good opposition. This is not a good opposition.
So generally, you need a lot of guts to come out in open like this, and generally you don't make statements as far as politics is concerned.
Why do I need guts to speak about anything in my country? It's my country. Arvind Kejriwal talks about films. He reviews films. So I can talk about him and I can talk about his party.
I have one question for you now, but I'll save it for later.
Sure.
So that I'll shoot in a very short while. Next, please.
Oscars what? No critics award, no popular award. Gosh, these guys, this is me being sarcastic. So our award ceremonies have become a joke nowadays. There's a Critics Award, Viewers' Choice Award, Internet Choice Award, Best Film Award. Look at the Oscars. There's one award, Best Film. That's it. What is going on? We've made a joke of the awards. The awards, our awards have just become TV shows.
All right, next please.
It's easy to believe in people when they're succeeding. Try to believe in them when they're failing. Now, these are just thoughts that come into my head randomly and I just put them on. Okay. Once, there's a very good cameraman, Ravi Chandran. One of the best DOPs in our country.
Right.
So once something happened and he said, what is this film this guy has made? He said, there's a message. You want to give a message, put it on Twitter. Don't make a film with that. And it's so right. You want to say something, you want to give a quick message, just put it on Twitter. So this thought must have come out.
And I just put
it on Twitter. So that's what you do. Just when you have a message to give, just put it on Twitter.
All right, next please.
Ashu Bhaiya, welcome. Just in case 140 letters aren't enough for you, you can use Twitter. Okay, this is just a dig at Ashu. He makes long movies, as we all know.
I know.
I call him Ashu Bhaiya. I don't know how that happened. So I always call him Ashu Bhaiya. So I was just pulling his leg because he needs 3 hours, 30 minutes to make a film. And some film was 3 hours, 15 minutes. I said, what? That's it? Sawa teen ghante ki picture, Ashu. Are you okay? Sab theek hai? So we have a healthy bond between us. There are a couple of us filmmakers who do not have, we have a rivalry, but it's a healthy competitiveness.
Competition, yes.
You know, we don't grudge each other. I mean, we filmmakers need to be honest with each other.
Right.
As a fraternity, we need to be honest with each other. We need to tell each other without maliciousness, without being mean or rude, you know, and saying, okay, your film is crap or your film is this. Just say that, okay, these things didn't work and these things work. We need to have the maturity to hear this instead of fakely praising it and going behind the back and saying, bakwas picture banaya.
All right. Next, what we have up for you happens to be almost last segment of the entire show, which is called In a Jiffy. All right. If you had to commit one crime, what would that be?
Robbery.
Okay. Do you cook?
I'm a very good cook, but really? I can never cook the same thing twice.
What are you most self-conscious about?
No, I'm very comfortable with myself to the point of being overconfident.
What fictional character you would want to be if given a chance?
I'd love to be Sherlock Holmes.
What's something too serious to be joked about, according to you?
Respected filmmakers.
What is the most craziest thing that you've done as a college boy?
Some girl broke up with me on 24th December and I was very upset and I had a quarter bottle of McDowell's number one in one shot and then the entire night I was doing crap. One of the things I can tell you about was I reached a bungalow in Juhu and there was some, because of me and my friends, there was some fight that happened and we jumped off of the first floor of the bungalow into the garden and then we ran onto the sea, onto the beach and ran away from there. These are the same things that I can tell you about.
Rest are all censored?
No, not censored. They're too dangerous to talk about. The rest of the things are too dangerous to talk about and people might try it.
The next thing we have here, okay. Send a Tweet is the segment we have as a part of In a Jiffy. What if you have to send a tweet to Narendra Modi? What would that be?
I would send a tweet saying, once upon a time there was a Lalu. Since Mahagathbandhan is over and Modi ji has got Nitish with him. So I would send a tweet saying, once upon a time there was a Lalu.
Chetan Bhagat.
He's very entertaining. But I don't follow him on Twitter, so I don't know what I would send to her.
Smriti Irani.
Let's have a ZTV reunion.
Oh, yes. All right. The next we have is, if following films are to be remade, whom would you cast? Mughal-e-Azam.
Aamir and Kajol.
Phool or Kate.
I think Ajay Devgan again, yeah.
The Intern.
Mr. Rishi Kapoor.
With the next segment that I jump onto, I just wanted to ask that, what have you to say on this, all three Khans? First, it was 100 crores, culture. Now it is 300 crore culture, which all three...
Now it's 500. Bahubali is on 500.
What have you to say on that culture?
I don't think the Khans have got this crore thing going on. The point to discuss is cinema. If you get an opportunity to sit in front of Tom Hanks, are you going to discuss with Tom Hanks or with Leonardo DiCaprio how many millions their films have grossed at the box office? I don't know where this fascination of 100 crore, 200 crore, 300 crore, 400 crore, 500 crore has come into the country.
So the moment the film releases, with the second, third day they start calculating.
Iski picture itne mein hit hai, iski picture itne mein flop. Arey yaar, picture kaisi hai, uske baare mein baat karo.
So the reason behind asking this question was the same, that you know, more than the craft of cinema or some creativity in the cinema which is involved by the director, people discuss the commerce part of it.
Arey picture ne 500 crore kiya, aapko kya mila? Achhi picture mili, picture achhi lagi, bas theek hai. You didn't like the film, don't like it. Whether it's done 100 crores or 200 crores or 500 crores, how does it matter to you?
The next we have is On the Rocks. Here, you have to rate out of 10. We start?
Rate what?
Whatever I announce. Okay. Begin with it. Daily soaps.
I don't watch.
Hindi version songs of Bahubali.
6.
Donald Trump as the president.
5.
Your laziness level?
8.
Bollywood parties?
2 on 10.
Okay, your school life?
10 on 10.
Imtiaz Ali films?
7 on 10.
Your writing skills?
I think 8.5, to be honest.
As a director?
8.5.
Okay, shooting abroad?
10 on 10.
Animation as a part of films, how would you rate that?
It's non-existent in India, yeah. There was one Hum Tum which had animation in films. After that, there's been no animation in films.
The next we have is like-dislike. So we have a placard, you just have to play around with that. Someone from the same sex flirting with you.
Tell you why. You gotta be open-minded. And I think it's flattering, yeah? It's flattering.
Being in front of camera, now you like, or it was from the beginning?
It's wonderful, it's good fun. Yeah?
Surya Vansham.
I've not seen the film.
Alright, the next we have is Snapchatting. Not on Snap. Instagram.
Instagram is fun.
Taking selfies? Kapil Sharma show?
It's great fun, yeah.
Going on promotional tours? Sitting on edit?
Oh, love. Love ka nahi hai kya?
Dressing up?
Actually, no. So, it's like this. Depends on my mood.
Being trolled on Twitter?
Better than being ignored.
Alright, the last segment we have now is awards. Alright, the first award is Angry Young Woman of Bollywood.
Nobody really. They're all pretty calm. Yeah. They're all pretty cool and calm.
Late Latif of Bollywood.
Fortunately, I've worked with everyone who's been very disciplined.
Best city to shoot in?
Yeh Bombay, meri jaan.
Best wedding song?
Mehndi laga ke rakhna.
Best cricketer?
Sunil Gavaskar.
Best short film?
I like that one Sujoy made. Or that doll or something. Or the doll where the guy just becomes a doll. Yeah, I like that.
It was wonderful chit-chatting with you. Thank you so much. We have a little thank you note for you.
Okay.
We have something to present you and...
Thank you.
Guess to you. I hope you had a good time.
Yes, I did. Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you.